Narrowboat Will is simply an awful chap that lives on a boat.
This is the visitor moorings. It's still a footpath, but I think over there it's
the wind's blowing behind us.
You get pretty bashed at that wall there. There's a load of bikes over there, look. It's like a biker's meeting place, this is. Have a look at the bikes over there. Seems alright here, the sun's come out. I mean, it's beautiful, isn't it? This is an absolute beautiful little place. Downside is a walk through to the housing estate, and you got these ropes that's across the walkway. It's a nice little journey, that. Really enjoyed it. 6 locks, 4 hours, and you got all the beautiful, you know, got all the beautiful hills in the background of the Lake District. I hope it's not school here. It's closed today. I don't know what it is. Here we go. Nice cup of tea and a sandwich. This is where you go out from the basin over. This is the swing bridge. You go out here and you go out into the sea thing. Morecambe Bay, Glasson Dock there. A quick look at this. That was open in 1787 as a newly developed. I'll start again. The dock was opened in 1787 as a new development. It offered a port for larger vessels unable to make the journey up the River Lune to the quays of Lancaster. Ships traded as far as the West Indies and the Baltic. Wow. A branch of the Lancaster Canal was built from Galgate to Glasson, 1826, giving a boost to the port. As road transport was so poor, it helped with the movement of heavy raw materials and finished goods. Blimey, look at that. All the ships in there, not ripping. Walking back for the van now, gonna look at the parking situation around here. In 1837, the year Queen Victoria came to the throne, shipbuilding began at Glasson Dock. Nicholson & Sons shipyard built 50 vessels here. The most famous was the schooner Rylands, launched in 1887. It used as the Hispaniola in the 1950 film of Treasure Island. Hispaniola. After more film and television work, she came to Morecambe as a tourist attraction as the Moby Dick. Sadly, she was destroyed by fire in 1970. Oh. Wow. Let's get going.
That's a locking off, that. Wow.
You ever been to the TT?
No.
Shame, isn't it, that building there?
Oh, it's bloody paying display, isn't it? Oh, great. Oh, look, pay by phone. Capture the market. Bastards. I was there.
Or just toilets.
I'd be surprised if there's showers.
Look at the estuary over there. Beautiful, look, the views. Over there, look, isn't it? Really nice. Really nice little area.
We walked over there. And their boats are getting battered by the waves. You know, they get the horrible noise on your hull and when the wind's blowing. But just here, it seems pretty nice. Nice views. Oh, it's such a lovely little area. I'll tell you in a few days what it's like. Seems okay at the moment. This is like a little walk through though. I don't know. People walk through, cut through here, so I don't know what it's like at the moment, you know. I'm just going to walk back to the van, and then apparently over there there's free parking. We asked in the calf, and they says, yeah, you can park out here. So we're going to go back there. There it's £5 for 24 hours in there, but you can park across the road for nothing. So don't tell anybody, secret between you and me, hey, rippers. Watched you, narrowboat Will. Do you remember? No, probably not.
No.
I watched you from the start when you painted your boat and everything.
Oh, right.
Oh, amazing.
When we had it.
Well, these have got their own vlogging channel. Oh, I've got the name of the channel now. Really nice people. I've watched them for ages. And what's your channel? I've seen you on YouTube. Good to meet you. Go to the far side to moor up on the Vista moorings.
On the
far side? Far side, yeah. Okay. See you there.
Thank you.
Hello, Peanut. Hello, Peanut. You all right, mate? He gives a filthy thumbs up.
I'm Bill.
Hello, Bill.
Yeah,
he's got filthy thumbs and he's got his shirt off. Look, nipple shot. Beautiful nipple shot. I'll beep that out. I'll do my own beep.
I thought you were gone.
No.
You've been up here since May.
I know, mate. I'm stuck on here now. I'm part of the furniture around here. I am now.
Well,
thanks for watching.
I've earned an ad whether to go on a little bit and stay 2 days here. I got Theakston's best bitter in the pub.
All right.
And I tell you, that's a beautiful pint of beer.
I don't drink, but I can get where you're coming from.
Well,
we're talking about booze, yeah, one way. We've been talking about it on the way up.
And then I thought I'd go back and spend.
So what pub?
The plough.
You recommend the Plough, do you?
Yeah. Good food.
Good food and a good pint in there.
Good pint, yeah. And don't go down the other one because they haven't got any real ale at all.
Okay, all right. Well, I'm not.
So if you go to Garstang, have you been to Garstang on the Thursday when it's market day?
I've been to Garstang, yeah. I'm going back to Garstang because the golf course there. I play golf and that's it for me.
Do you stop at the butcher there?
No. Is there a good butcher there as well?
There's a queue there from when he opens till a bit later on.
Oh, really, excellent. Really good. Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
I will do it then. I'm going to Garstang. I want to get...
I said lamb swirls.
What's that? Lamb swirls?
Yeah, so you've just gone out for them. You'll see them in there. They're about like that and that thick, but they're swirled, got pastry
in
them.
Yeah, I'll look into that.
Chuck them in the oven and that's it. Really
I'll look into that. Thanks for watching.
That's all right, mate.
What's it called?
Frosta Tithe Barn.
Tithe, and you got the biggest tithe barn in?
In the country.
In the country, down at Gloucester.
12th, 13th century.
And you're at Saw.
I live in Saw.
You live in Saw at Gloucester. Yeah, when I go down.
You turn up in Saw Basin, so I walk up there every day.
Yeah.
In the winter.
Yeah.
And if you're up there, I'll give you a bang on the roof.
Fantastic.
All right.
These two vloggers are called Never More Than Four. Never more than four, I think it is. Oh dear, that wind's gonna take you. Oh, that wind, no! No, 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 no! Bang, hold on! Oof. It's windy. There's a bollard here, look. Let me give you rope. Whoa! That's how you get in. That's how you get in. You've got to throw your rope. I've got a moored here because the boats seem to be getting battered over there from the wind. That lapping that you get. Lapping sound you get on the hull. When the tide comes in, this is what happens to this section here. Fishermen can go out fishing, etc., so forth and so on. Don't know how you get down there. I'd like to know how you get down to the end. I don't know. I thought this duck was in the lock for, because sometimes when you go in with your boat, swans or ducks will follow you in. I thought it was trapped in there and it was just waiting to get out. Someone's going to let it out. I don't know what species. I've never seen one before. Very, very unusual. Beautiful chicks. So cute. It's an interesting little place, this is. Like a hidden gem, Mr. Van Parkin. The estuary, you can walk down, sunny days, lots of wildlife, birds. You can walk down, cycle down, you can even skip and whistle if you want. They've even got their own little bowling green, surrounded by flowers, beautiful. A local just told me, because I talked to everybody, morning, how are you doing? You alright? Yeah. Stop parping, says to a dog, stop parping about. I says, pub, I thought she meant pub, sounded like from London. Ooh, going to a pub, or pap, you're not me. She says, no, stop parping around, it's the saying around here, apparently. Get on with it, it means. P-A-R-P, parp. Stop parping around, Will, and get on with it. I am doing, look. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm going for little walkie-poos. This really must be the jewel of Lancaster, I think, this basin. You've really got to come down here and see this, it's stunning. I mean, just around the corner is a golf course. Ashton Hall Golf Course. A couple of miles away, I'm going to play there later. It's only a 9-hole thing, it's not very nice. Next door to that, you've got Lancaster Golf Club, if any golfers out there. Is there any out there? Hello? Hello, is anybody there? So, yeah, you've got everything around here. You've got all the facilities, parking, and you've got those next door to me lot. And their beautifully coloured boat. Nice couple. Really nice couple, bless them. Never More Than Four, it's called. Never More Than Four. It's only a little channel. It's a nice little calm. Done their boat up, and now they're travelling around. And I just admired her. Actually, admired her dress sense, to be honest. She's always dressed really nice. And the colourfulness of the boat. I admire the work that went into that. Oof. You know, especially trying to touch it up. You scrape it. Once you scrape down the line down the side, you've got to touch about 15 different colours up. Anyway, that's 15 different tins opening with 15 different skins on them. Because paint doesn't last, does it? Been talking to another local down there, and he said that this is an old disused railway just here. Look, it takes you all the way down, there. You can cycle it, and you go up onto the canal, come back down the canal, and back down to the basin. And he said, up here at the top of the hill, I walked up earlier. So you get to the top of that hill, there's a viewing point. You can see all of Blackpool and everywhere. So, what? I walked up that hill, I got to near the top of the foot, there's nothing here. I turned around. Ah, now I've got to walk back. Why? Am I so uninquisitive? Still loading the ships here, look. See that? Still loading and unloading at high tide. It's just a fabulous area, it really is. You've got so much going on. Got the estuary, got the The old railway, the canal. If you're posh, it's called the Conal. The Conal the Barbarian. No, it's not. It's not. Look at him loading that, look. See that? Still loading. Unloading like they used to. Well, whenever, last year, year before. Probably from the early times, you know, the little unloaded and loaded there. That little crane thing, look, isn't that weird? Really old thing as well, by the looks of it. What's that van? Oh, God, eh? What's that van? There we are, that's the end of that. I don't know if you can see that, but look at the difference from this teacup spray on. This has got to be spray on from Halfords. Look at the difference in paint. And when it goes milky like that, it's very quick. I spent 10 minutes on it. Look at the difference in paint. Wow, I'm chuffed. Just got that to do now, I'm knackered already. Turned out beautiful now. This is the gem for me, this place. It's beautiful. Don't know how long the moorings are, there's no signs, so I'm just gonna stay here for a week. Just enjoy the ambience of the place. Until it gets thundery and rainy and windy. Apart from that, good. It appears these ducks have been stuck in there for quite a few hours, so they've come down to try and get them out and rescue them, you know. Are they getting those chicks out? Are they getting the chicks out? What are they getting out?
Some
birds. Yeah, I saw them this morning.
Well, they got them out once.
Yeah, they do get in here, don't they? They're rare, those birds. They're rare. Never seen one.
What, shell duck?
No.
You've never seen one?
No.
Where have you been?
All around the country.
Eh?
All around the country.
You've never seen one?
Not one of these.
Really?
No. Very, very unusual. Can't they open the gates?
It's open.
It's open, yeah. You get a lot of this when you're travelling on the boat, you know. I mean, I live on a boat. I don't see many shell, what's it called, shell drakes.
What about here?
Yeah.
You're not gale then, would
you? No, I don't. I travel all over the place.
What, here?
Yeah.
Well, you haven't been travelling so much. If you've got a boat in here, you can't get it out.
Yeah, come down the locks.
Hmm?
Come down the lock.
Canal.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's different, isn't it?
Oh.
Huh? I've seen lots of shell ducks all over the place.
It's unusual. I've never seen one.
Lots of them.
I sent a film to
my dad's over there. Look,
I sent a film to my mate about it.
Oh, my dad's there.
Yeah.
Over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. I saw this morning. I saw them in here, and I thought they're going to either get out or someone's going through the lock. At least I've got them out now. I'm trying to catch them out. Oh, they're there, look. They're so cute, aren't they? They're so cute. Can you see mine there, look? Mine's the adjuster bracket there. You got the same one underneath. Undo that nut. Pull the alternator tighter and tighten it back up again. All right, yours will be underneath, same shape.
Need to tighten that bracket there. Which way do I pull the alternator? Right or left, from what you can see? I'm guessing that's the alternator there. I need to tighten that bracket up, yeah?
Hello. My neighbours have invited me to for dinner tonight, 6:30. My neighbours next door. Vloggers, never more than four. All sort of rhymes, doesn't it, all that? I don't want to be a prat, so I've got to be myself and all that. Oh, come on, stop trying to rhyme everything now, Will. Anyway, I'm going to dinner next door, 6:30. It's now 6:15. So a quick shower. Now I'm going to go and get something to eat, I'm starving. Windy. Windy here. It's a windy part of the world. But I love it. I'm going to stay here for as long as I can, really, I think. Here we go. Lovely boat, isn't it? Look at this. That's a bit of a step.
Ooh. Hello.
Oh, this is a nice boat in here, isn't it? I like the entrance.
Don't have to say mind your head, do I?
It smells good. Oh, did you do the artwork at the back? I can't remember.
No,
it's... I made it all this, didn't you?
It's called Photo Wall.
Oh, is it? You just... fitted all this out, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. These are nice and high, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. You made this, didn't you? I'm sure you did.
Yeah.
Yeah, you made it. You've done all this boat, haven't you?
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. I love it, boat.
From the table, in fact.
You never quite get the gist till you see it in person, do you?
No.
You're proud of it then? You happy with it?
We are actually, aren't we?
Yeah. Would you change anything in it?
All the time.
Yeah. I mean, everything that we did seems to have worked out all right as well.
This is a nice big space as well, isn't it?
Exactly, which is exactly what we wanted to do, rather than have those tiny little spaces where you've got a television screen there.
Yeah.
And you're sitting looking at it like that.
No. Yeah, but you're saying this and Will might have that.
No, I've got a TV.
True, yeah.
I've got a TV there, but I don't watch TV.
No, well, you've got a computer.
Yeah, I don't watch TV, but I've got an IKEA corner sofa.
Have you? Yeah.
Because it's all got all the storage underneath.
Yeah, this is all storage under here.
Isn't this a lovely little spot here, isn't it? And you're double glazed, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'm double glazed. And your channel is?
Never More Than Four.
Yeah. Your names are?
I'm Fran.
Fran.
And I'm Henry.
Henry, thank God for that. I forgot your names.
Did you?
Give us a thumbs up. Thumbs up. Yay! Filthy thumbs up from you. Nice one. Cheers. Thanks for the dinner.
Right.
Well, I'll tell you in a minute if it's any good or not. It looks nice. What is it anyway?
It
smells nice.
It's like a tortilla.
It smells. What's this?
That's a crumble for afterwards.
Oh, God. Thank God for that. Beautiful. What's all this?
That are biscuits.
Oh, lovely. Do you make them yourself?
Yeah.
You're very arty, aren't you? You're very arty and you're very...
I am an artist. That's what my job is.
Is it really?
Yeah.
What? So you're still doing it now?
Yeah, I teach in the winter and make a collection of work every winter. So I am also the ceramic gardener. So
all
I
right.
make botanic sculpture from clay.
What's your website? Have you got a website?
It's my name, Frances Doherty. But on Instagram, I'm the ceramic gardener. So I've got two Instagram accounts.
All right, okay.
Way to Blue, that's the name of the boat. Never More Than Four.
Never More Than Four.
And ceramic gardener.
Ceramic gardener, yeah. Okay. Oh, very nice. I can't film for long because I'm running out of space.
Yeah, well.
I've got so much. I've got 128 gigs on this phone. I've got about four left.
You're allowed to get rid of stuff, you know.
No, I can't because it's all vlogging stuff because all my vlogs are on this phone and all my editing's on this phone. There's nothing stored on computer and nothing. If it drops in the canal, all my vlogs have gone.
Oh, really?
It's finished, yeah.
We've got ours set to rendered videos.
What's that mean?
Our vlogs. It's what you set up in the editing suite. So then once you render it, it goes into a folder called Rendered Videos, which is off.
Because I render each one as I'm doing it, you see. I'll render it,
yeah.
And I'll delete the ones I've just done and uploaded
it.
Yeah. If I delete them before I upload them, it'll delete them in the render sort of thing.
So you haven't got a computer?
I've got a laptop, but I've never used it.
Okay.
Never use it.
So ours will go from the editing suite into a folder on the computer called rendered videos automatically.
Wow.
And then
I couldn't work that out. It's just doing my head in. I can't stand all that stuff. This is enough for me, this phone. This is a new phone, and this is enough for me. And that's it. Everything's on my phone, editing, filming, yeah, and everything.
It's so much easier to edit on computer, though. You've got...
Yeah, but I can sit on toilet having a dump and still edit.
Too much information.
And still edit, you know?
Okay,
mate. Very nice, thank you.
Well, just help yourself to potatoes and kale.
Lovely. Looking forward to this. I've starved myself. This is your website. This is what you make out of clay. Wow, look at the detail.
It's all...
You make this out of clay and you paint it and you
fire
it.
And I fire it and I glaze it.
That's gorgeous, isn't it?
A lot of it goes into the garden. So it's...
Look at that, it's so beautiful. Wow.
Yeah.
So you take pictures from the sea and you just copy it and you design your own thing.
Yeah, I sort of...
Wow. Is that swearing in the background?
It's FIP Radio, French radio station. So that's
like, your students make this.
The students make this, and none of them have worked with clay before.
That's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. So
it's nice to say. It's nice you've got something physical that it's tactile. It's you can touch it, and it's in your room. And you say, "I made that." You go, "Wow, that's nice, pretty, isn't it?"
Yeah, that's in the kiln.
Wow.
Out of the kiln.
Getting fired.
That's the students making the work.
Students doing their studing. I've got something on my lens. Yeah, very nice. Oh, wow, that is gorgeous, isn't it? Wow, that is such a nice colour.
It's like a little jewellery box.
Oh, isn't
it?
Oh, it's lovely. I love the colour in here. It's just a bright, it's just a colour. Wow. And there's your big old bed at the end. Oh, that's a nice space, isn't it?
Yeah, king size.
You're not disturbing each other, so one can climb out in the middle of the night and not disturb the other one. You've got loads of storage. You're very conscious about your dress sense, aren't you?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You are, aren't you? I'm going to show this fire quickly. This fire is a... What's it called?
Fire ethanol.
It runs on ethanol. What you do is you put your ethanol in the bottom of there into a cup, isn't it?
Yeah, you just squirt it in from a bottle.
I'm squirting it from a bottle into the bottom there. Light it and just, that's it. It's smokeless. It's bio, so you don't get any fumes. You don't need a chimney and nothing. So you've got no chimney, it's just pure heat, and when it runs out, you just fill it up again.
Yep.
Wow. Yeah. So that's not the fire, though. That's a French one you got from a... That's a French fire from an antique shop.
So that's how it comes, and that lasts the whole evening, 4 or 5 hours.
Wow.
And it works out at about 60p an hour?
Something like that.
Yeah, well, coal's 7 hours, isn't it? Where'd you get this from?
I order it online. They deliver it.
Yeah, that's you can't just go willy-nilly buy it from B&Q, can you?
No.
Well, problem with these things.
You can buy it in the camping shops now, but they'll charge a tenner for something like that instead of £2.
96.6
alcohol.
Very nice.
It comes, and it's made in this country, and it comes from the sugar beet industry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All these starlings. Wow. All the babies are talking to each other. I've learned a lot about wildlife and history and stuff like that, just being a narrowboater.
Do you find that your day is really made if you see a kingfisher?
Yeah, I see loads of them.
God.
Yeah, I see loads of them.
Whenever I see a kingfisher, I'm smiling.
Just don't stay in one spot. I run to my window, put the old phone there! And the time you get there, it's gone.
You usually see them.
It's coming towards them.
The lawnmower's coming.
Starlings on your garden lot. I wonder what they're eating. Must be picking worms or something. My creation myself.
I went through it and I couldn't get the software.
I'm just in the process. I've sanded that down. I'm going to paint it. I'm not going to film it all because I'm running out of space. This thing is completely rotten. That's got to come off and be done at some point when I get near a B&Q. There's always something in there. This is completely gone, look. Rotten to high heaven. So take all this apart, take the screws out, take the wood off, and then I don't know, if I just replace the wood and paint it.
Right, let's crack on.